Hey, what's up, guys? So I got a few questions, like just kind of asking how I train. So obviously how I train changes throughout the year, depending on where we are, like in terms of like competition. But right now we're about 4.5 weeks out. So I'm taking you guys through like a full training session. I'm gonna try to run through all the warmups I do, all the dynamic stretching and everything I do, like pre-lifting. But basically the way I train is I have 5 days a week where I'm training. So what I do is if we start on Monday is either an upper or a lower day. Tuesday is the opposite, so upper or lower. Wednesday was whatever Monday was. Thursday is whatever Tuesday was. Rest on Friday. SBD day on Saturday, and then rest on Sunday. So the way it's kind of broken up is 3 times a week frequency, upper and lower. In terms of specific movements, we're doing the bench press 3 to 4 times a week, the squat 2 to 3 times a week, and the deadlift 1 to 2 times a week. So obviously Saturday is the most specific day. It's almost like a competition, even if not doing singles. It's still like a competitive, it's still like mimicking a competition where you're gonna have to do all 3 lifts on the same day. So technically it's like a full body day, but really it's more based on like the movements. Like it's oriented towards the movements versus the actual body parts being worked. But today we're gonna warm up. I'm gonna try to go through some low bar squats and then some sumo deadlifts. Hopefully get them to about 600 pounds on the squat and about mid sevens on the deadlift. What's up, Ryan?
What's up?
Wanna say hello to the people? This is Ryan Mezavie.
What's up, y'all?
He's a dedicated gym goer. But yeah, I wanna take you guys through a few like things I do pre-squatting. So I don't do a whole lot of static stretching. Mostly it's dynamic stretching. So I'm gonna run you guys through a little bit of mobility for the ankle, for the hip, and just a few things I do just to kind of cue good like torso mechanics, good bracing mechanics. And then we'll just be jumping straight into the squats. So thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna try to do some voiceover over the actual training clip so I can kind of keep talking more in depth about everything that's going on. But thank you guys for watching. Back. We just finished up the squats. The squats went okay. I didn't feel super explosive today. Like every time I hit the hole, I just didn't feel like I had that like pop, like that drive out of the bottom. We started up to 606. I hit it for a pretty clean set of six, probably about RP 7 to 8. I definitely had some more reps. They just like, they didn't feel super explosive today. I think I could have hit 8 today, but it didn't really feel like the day to do it. I don't feel great today. Still kind of beat up from Saturday, honestly. Even though that was like 4 days ago, it was just a really heavy session. So, I'm kind of losing my voice too. So, I'm gonna go into some deadlifts now. I'm gonna be pulling on the stiff bar and using pound plates just because I want to get some reps in. So I want to work up to about eight plates, 45s, about 765. And I kind of have a range of like 3 to 6 that I'd like to hit. I think if I feel really good, I might be kind of talking out of my ass here, but I think I can hit like 8 if I feel good. The stiff bar feels really good for me. I feel super just connected to the bar. There's not a lot of slack to pull. So it really complements my style of pulling where I'm fairly explosive. I almost yank on the bar. So if there's hardly any slack to pull and I yank and I have immediate tension with all the weight, it's a lot easier usually to just kind of jump off the ground and then just keep it fast, keep it explosive all the way to lockout. But I'm gonna start warming up for deadlifts. I probably won't record all of these. I'm probably just gonna take plate jumps all the way up. So I'll probably record like 495 and up from there. But here we go, let's get this shit.